This is owned by, or operated by, Reefbird Energy, which is one of the sort of two big ones in the urban oil fields of Los Angeles. You can see the sort of separation tanks, you know, so when you pull stuff out of a well, it's water, it's gas, and it's oil, and you got to separate those things out. So these different tanks are for storage of water and gas. And they also have injection wells here and at most of these urban well sites. So they, some of the wells are used to inject water that comes out from the wells, and also they use the water to stimulate production, to they force it in to force oil out. And they also inject steam in some cases to help sort of liquefy and force the oil out of the wells. The entire Sawtelle oil field, which is underneath us, it's been active for a long time. This last year, it was 184,000 barrels came out of this site. And so this is kind of a typical kind of urban oil drilling site. There's about 8 or 10 things similar to this in the LA basin. We won't look at all of them, but we will look at a few.
All right, this site is called a consolidated urban drill site, and it was built in the early 80s. At the time, the city had oil wells kind of all over the place, like down in Long Beach, where you'll see one, you know, in the parking lot of a restaurant or something. And so this brought everything in together in one consolidated site. There's 15 producing wells. We make about 400 barrels of oil a day. We make about 2,500 barrels of water a day that's commingled with the oil. So we have to get that oil dry for shipping purposes. So we have ways to separate the oil and water, basically retention time and chemical, because oil's heavier. You know, if you shake up your salad dressing, the oil and vinegar are gonna separate after a while. The oil then, when it's clean, is shipped via pipeline, and our pipeline goes over to a vault on Pico. It ties into a couple other fields over there and then ends up heading towards the ConocoPhillips refinery.
Thousand barrels of oil were produced here in 2008. 2.2 million barrels of water. There's compressors, there's noise that's created by the pump jacks, and of course deliveries. There are odors, sort of sulfurous and asphalty smells, which are not pleasant to everybody. And there's the sort of visual confusion that occurs when something that's pretty much an industrial occupancy is living, you know, shoulder to shoulder with residences.
This is PXP Corporation's lease. They were not willing to meet us out here. They're involved in all kinds of litigation, apparently. There'll be more on that later. So if we could just stick together, walk around to the front of the building. We'll talk about it right outside the front door there.
Are 51 oil and gas wells, 13 water injection wells. Production in 2008 was 491,000 barrels of oil, which is substantial. 5.7 million barrels of water were produced, and then 763 million cubic feet of gas, which is enough to serve some 10,000 households. So the energy production on this site, even though this is considered mature and depleted, is still significant and warrants the site continuing to operate. A lot of times the conditions of approval that the city hands down require them to be permanently staffed.
And also to post their phone number. So if you notice on the side, there's a phone number, and you call that, and odds are you'll talk directly to somebody who's associated with the site. Though you might also just listen to Vivaldi. Yeah, it's occurred to me at least one of these locations.
So we're on the westernmost edge of the next oil field, the Las Cienegas field, which is accessed through three active sites, this being one of the inactive ones, one of two I think that are inactive, but we'll visit, rather than visit all of them, we'll just look at one of them, and that'll be our next stop, so we can continue forward. As they repressurize these wells, they kind of force things out, and there have been tar seeps and ooze emerging in the vicinity of this oil drilling site. And there's some apartment complex a couple blocks away, we'll point out, which actually had to be evacuated at some point a couple of years ago because of gas. And maybe Ben knows more about the situation than I do.
And St. James had, they had received a grant basically to put together a pilot project to use a different type of acid stimulation where they pump acids down into the ground to sort of open up the rock structures that the petroleum is in order to get more out. And it was an interesting technology to everybody because, it makes the... you get more out of the same area, but apparently they were kind of operating outside of the thresholds that they were supposed to in terms of the pressure that they were injecting things into the ground. And as a consequence, on Olive Street up here, kind of a tarry type stuff, which was not identified initially, started oozing out of storm sewers and into the basement of this apartment building. It resulted in a lawsuit. The city of LA sued the operator, and they're not really that interested in talking to the public as a consequence.
Thought that this might be the last pump in the LA City oil field, and it turns out it is. So in a way, this is historic. How are things going? Is it going to be here a bit longer,
yeah,
forever?
We plan on pumping it till it's all gone. It currently is doing between 4 and 5 barrels of oil a day. It used to do about 8. Basically, in the 1890s, they discovered oil in the city of Los Angeles, and they started drilling. By 1895, 1897, they were doing about 750,000 barrels a year. There was over 500 wells, I don't know, by 1900, over 500 wells in the city of Los Angeles.
Uh-huh.
So there's been a lot of wells here.
Yeah.
Every street through here has had wells.
So can you, is this like the smallest size you can get?
Sure. This is the pumping is, you can actually get them pretty small. But as far as space for a tank farm, this is about as small as you're going to get.